Students, today I'll be teaching how to use MicroVision 4 Field software for executing your hardware programs. So this is the Field software. When you double click on the icon on the desktop, you'll get this window. So you need to select new project. Click on project, select new MicroVision project. Once you click on that, you'll be asked to fill type the file name. So you type some file name and you need to store it in the corresponding folder, whichever is created. So click on save, project is created. And it will ask for search option. In the search option, so you have to type LPC2148. So we are going to use LPC2148 microcontroller. So search LPC2148, then click on OK. So copy startup.s to project folder and add file to project. You have to click on yes. So here your target one and then startup.s file is being created. So now after this, you have to go to file, click on file, then select option new. So an editor will be opened here. So this is the place where you have to type your program. So already we have a program for 7-segment display. So this is the program we have to type here. So once the program is typed, you have to check for errors. That is your debugging. So you have to debug. So before that, you have to save the file. So click on file and then save. Give the file name with the extension C. So .c, we are using embedded C. So in the same folder, you have to save the file with the extension .c. So now your file is saved. Once your file is saved, you have to add your file to source group. So click on source group 1, you should right click on source group 1, then add existing files to group. So you click on that and select your particular file. So this is your particular file, then click on add and then close. So your file is visible here. After that, you have to build target, that is your debug session. So this is the icon you can use for build target, or directly you can use F7, or you can go to debug option. So this is the icon you can choose, build. So if you click on this build, so you'll be able to see here the errors and warnings. If no errors are there, it will display zero errors. So your file is ready for execution. So this is the debugging or compilation process. Once your file is ready for execution, so now this particular program, you need to send it to board, because this is a hardware program, you have to execute on the board. So you have on LPC2148 board, evaluation board. On that board, this program will be executed. So now how to send this program to that board? You cannot send the program as it is. So you have to send the executable file or the machine code. So how to create the executable file or machine code means it's a creation of hex file. So you have to create hex file. So how to create that hex file means you have option called as flash here. So you have to send this to the board using Flash Magic interface. So for that, you have to configure the tools or the settings under Flash. So click on Flash, then select configure Flash tools. So in that, the first one is device and then target. So in that target, you have to click on use micro lib. So then output, click on output. Here you have to click create hex file. So this is compulsory. You have to click on create hex file. So this will create you your hex file, so that hex file will be taken to the board for execution. Then linker, you need to select the first option, use memory layout from target dialog. So these are the options you have to check on the flash tools. So after doing that, click on OK. So now again, you save it and then build target. So once you click on this build target, you have to get a message here like creating hex file. So this message is compulsory. So if you get this message creating hex file, so that is the meaning that your file is ready for execution. So now once your file is ready for execution, so we have to see the settings for Flash Magic. So Flash Magic is a tool which is used for interfacing your program to the board. So now I will show you the Flash Magic. So how to use the Flash Magic. So this is the Flash Magic screen you can see here. So here you will be having 5 steps. So step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4 and step 5. So in step 1, you will be setting all the communication related options. That means what is the device you are using. You have to select the device as LPC2148 and then communication port. Depending upon your settings, you have to check which communication port you have to choose. So here I have chosen communication port 1, then baud rate 9600, then interface none ISP, then oscillator 12. So this is the values you have to remember and set. When it comes to the step 2, you have to choose this arrays blocks used by hex file. So this option you have to choose. And when you come to this portion, that is step 3, browse. So browse is nothing but the file whichever you have created, hex file. So that file you have to choose and click on open. So that file will come here, and this is the file which you want to execute on the board. So in step 4, verify after programming. So this part you have to click. So you have to click on verify after programming. Once you finish all these 4 steps, 5th step is start. So if you click on the start button, your program will get executed on the board. So you have to click on start button for executing your program on the board. Once you click on the start button, your program will get executed in the board. So now you can see the Flash Magic settings, which will be used as an interface to send your program from the Keil software to the board. So there are 5 steps in the Flash Magic. Step 1 is communication, wherein you'll be selecting the device, communication port, baud rate, all these things. So device is LPC2148, communication port is COM1, baud rate is 9600, interface none, then oscillator 12 MHz. In step 2, you have to click on this arrays blocks used by hex file. Step 3 is browsing or selecting your hex file, the corresponding hex file you have to browse. Click on browse, go to your folder, select the file, click on open. So your corresponding file will be selected which you want to execute. So step 4, verify after programming. You have to click on this verify after programming. So after finishing all these steps, step 1 to step 4, final step is click on start. So if you click on start, your program will execute, and on the board you will be able to see your output. Now we will learn the experiment external interrupt program. So when external interrupt, any interrupt is given, so to check whether that external interrupt is working or not, we are going to have one LED here. So this external interrupt is nothing but this switch. So you can see here one switch is there. So if you press that switch, this LED will be glowing on. Again, if you press that switch, LED will off. So the experiment is external interrupt to glow LED on or off depending upon the previous status. So this experiment, again, we are running using the ARM7 LPC2148 evaluation board. And this is the microcontroller chip, LPC2148 microcontroller chip, which we are going to use on this LPC2148 evaluation board. So again, to give the power connection for this board, so you need to use this power up connection and then RS232 serial port. So this you need to connect the system where you have to take the hex file from the system to run, and 2 jumpers you need to connect. So this is jumper number 21, so you need to connect here. So in this external interrupt, you have 2 external interrupt pins. One is external interrupt 0 and the other one is external interrupt 1. So this JP7 you need to short. For all experiment, you need to short JP7, and this is another one, JP21. So you can see here, this is your external interrupt 0 and this is your external interrupt 1. So in our program, we have programmed for external interrupt 0. So that is the reason we need to use this switch. So whenever you press this switch, the corresponding LED you can see here, it will glow or it will off. For each time when the switch is pressed, it will be on or off. So this is the jumper connections you have to make for this experiment. So we'll check the execution part now. So
So now LED is on. Previous state, already the LED was on. So if I press this switch, now it becomes off. It goes to the off state. So this is your external interrupt. Based on that external interrupt, your LED is going to on or off. So again, if I press this external interrupt or switch, so LED is on. Again, if I press it, it becomes off. So this is on, off, execution of the external interrupt experiment.